Hello guys, so welcome to KO Tutorials. So we are going to start with the next part of this tutorial. So let's get started. So as you can see over here, we have started with the modeling part of this truck over here. So we'll be continuing with this part. So how we are going to make this part is like, so there are different things how we are going to model this part. So very first of all, for creation of this part, what I'll be doing over here is like, I have two things. Either I can start with a box also, or either I can go into this and I can just take a cube over here. After taking this cube section over here, I'll increase its height over here. Let's just increase its height over here. Make sure you are increasing its height more till here. So after you are done with this, we can just increase its radius a bit over here and just push it till here. So now what I'll be doing over here is like, so let's select this part and increase its sides over here. This is one method which I'm showing you right now. So reduce its height segments and convert to editable poly. Let's go into this, select this, polygons over here, and can just delete this polygons easily. After you are done with this, what we will be doing over here is like, we will be just selecting this over here and let's just extrude it in this direction. So just scale it, just scale this stuff over here. After that, again select this over here, exclude this part and again extrude it in this direction, scale it, and definitely I'll be just pushing this down. I'll select this, I'll make it straighter. So select this, press R and scale, make it more straighter, select this and push it in this way. After that, we'll just select the top polygons over here. We'll be just selecting the top polygons over here and let's just extrude this up over here and scale it. So please go on scaling with this stuff over here. You scale a bit till half of it and again extrude this up. Go into the vertices and just push it in this way. So this is a good method to generate such stuff if you look at this over here. After that, let's go into this and again use a Swift loop over here. Ring this. Control and click on this. Polygons over here. And just give a bit of bevel to it. And reduce this. And click OK. After that, we also have some more references of this particular truck over here. We'll be coming through this details. First, we'll just model the basic stuff first. So let's go into this and let's push it in this way over here. After that, let's select this polygons, and if I want to delete this, I can easily delete this polygons. So I'll just delete this and this in this way. Or else, if you want, you can just use a bit of bevel into it, so we can just push it inside over here and just bevel this element over here. So now what we'll be doing over here is, like, we are just doing some basic stuff for now. Just add one more swift loop over here. So select this polygon over here, just push this up, select this, so select this and just extrude it up and just push this down, more down. Let's select this and let's give chamfer over here and click OK. So once you give chamfer, it's definitely going to work in that particular way. So now again, I'm going to use one more swift loop. Let's save your file first. Let's take one more swift loop over here. So let's take this over here. So for the mirrors, what we'll be doing is, like, we'll be just scaling it more. So just push this till here. Go into the material and I'll just assign the same material for now. I'll go into this. We'll just assign a normal material because I don't need much shiny right now. So let's use a swift loop over here. Let's use one swift loop over here. Let's use one over here. One over here. So you can press 4 over here, and definitely you can go with the inset option for now over here. So I can use this edge. I'll delete this edge over here. I'll put one edge over here. Much better now. So select this and this and use a bit of inset over here. Click OK. And we'll just use a bit of bevel if required. and click OK. So if you go into this edges over here, and if you want to go with the chamfer option, you can go with the chamfer option over here, not a problem, much better. So select this over here again, and looks more of a box shape, so we'll make it more curvy over here. So let's just push this a bit up. We need to put some loops over here also, so let's add some loops over here in this direction. So let's just select this and just give a bit of a roundish look over here. And also you can go to the top view over here. You can just select this or elements, and if you want you can just push it out to give it a bit of a curvy look over here, and select this and this. You can slowly just push it behind if required. Much better. Let's use one swift loop here. Let's use one here. So if you want, you can just go into this and give a FFD box over here, and go into this, make it 6 by 6 by 6 over here. Let's go into its control points over here and just give a bit of a curvy look wherever it is required. So you can just go on to this view also, and if you want to go with this, you can give a bit of a curvy look over here. Much better. So if you're done, you can just right click and convert to poly again over here. So let's just save your file and isolate this. Definitely we'll be doing some more detailings on this right now. So we'll just push this over here in this way and put some more details over here. Let's use some more details over here. Let's put some details over here also. So right click and let's use a cut option over here. So can just join this much better. So save your files, keep on saving your files, that's much better. Okay, so we'll go with this details afterwards. Before that, what we'll be doing over here is, like, we are going to create some shape over here like this shape. So for that, we'll go into this view over here and we'll just take a line over here. Just take a line over here just take a line shape over here, and enable in viewport rectangular and increase its width over here. So we can just push this up over here in this way. And now we can shift it more front further and convert to editable poly. So again I will use one swift loop over here and one over here to select the polygons over here, and let's just give extrude over here. Click OK. So if you look at it very closely over here, so this part will go in this way, this part will go in this way, and this all will come up. So we'll not push it fully up, but we'll definitely push this more up over here. Much better. So now in this, definitely we'll just shift it a bit inside over here. Push it up. Alright. So if you want to go with this, you can go with that, not a problem. And we'll give the chamfering stuff afterwards. For now we'll just keep it over here in this way. So just save your file over here. So guys, if you have any doubts, please write it in the comment section. And if you want me to make any other tutorial on any other topics, please put it in the comment section. So please like and subscribe my YouTube channel, that's KO Tutorials. So thanks for watching this tutorial.